Alright, this match with... This is not a match at all. Alright, this is an Eldritch Moon 8-4 draft. Might be Savage Alliance here. What's our first pick here? Could be Elfinwald Captive. That guy's very good. I don't think it's Oath of Liliana. Not the best rare to be opening. Might be Savage Alliance. Deal one to all dudes. Two to another dude. And then a dude gets Trample. Is that better than, like, Elfinwald Captive? Captive is very, very good. I'm going to go with the Captive. I'm not thrilled with Savage Alliance here. I think green is a stronger color in this set. And look, we would have got nothing in this pack. Just nothing. I think Scuttler's one of the better picks in this pack, to be honest with you. I like Faith Unbroken, but it's very, very easy to get blown out by it. It's like, just... You just kill the dude, and then you get your guy back, and it's just a 2-for-1 for them. I like Shrill Howler a lot here. Yeah, let's go with the Howler. I think it's better than Gnarwhal Dryad. It doesn't commit us to another color. And maybe something will come back. One can only hope. People are taking a lot longer than I am, that's for sure. It's always awkward when you're in the middle of a draft and like the picks are taking long and you're like, do I say something or do I just leave it? It's real awkward. I got two Flip Wolves though. All right. Crypt Breaker is actually pretty good. Huh. I like that a lot. I also like Midnight Scavengers. So, black is definitely the color that's pretty open here. I think we're just taking the Crypt Breaker. Maybe that's real good. Yeah, I'm gonna try that, dude. I like It of the Horde Swarm, but this doesn't strike me as a deck that's gonna play Eldrazi yet. I'm gonna take these Graph Rats because that's a dude that we can just take a Midnight Scavengers and feel pretty good about it. Primal Druid. And Extricator of Sin. I don't think it's Extricator. I don't think we're gonna go white for this random dude. I don't even think he's that great, actually. Like, you have to sacrifice a creature, a non-Eldrazi creature, to make an Eldrazi creature. Like, it's fine. I think we're just gonna go Primal Druid. Or we can take the Withered Vampire and have something to discard to Crypt Breaker. I think it's actually Withered Vampire. It does cost us 5 to do that, though. It's still a 2-2 and a 3-3, though. Yeah, we'll just take the Vampire. Ooh, I like a Dusk Feaster. 4-5 Flyers are just good. If we have Delirium, that's fine. I mean, like, if it costs 7, it costs 7. I think it's Dusk Feaster. We also have a couple Vampires now, which is nice. The only other option is Succumb to Temptation, but I don't really want to play that. Another weirded Vampire. I think we're just going to take the Certain Death here because I'd rather have a removal spell. Hopefully we'll get some more. We actually might not even be green here, to be fair, so there's no reason to commit to the green here. I think our black is very good, but our green is good, but Prey Upon definitely convinces me to be green now. That's a very late Prey Upon. Is that an 8th pick Prey Upon? That's pretty solid. So if someone wants to keep passing the green cards, I'm okay with it. Also, just being able to turn excess lands into 2/2s and then draw extra cards seems pretty good. Also, if we do get a Midnight Scavengers, we just get back a Crypt Breaker with it. Seems legit. Mockery of Nature. I don't know why this one's so expensive. It does destroy an enchantment or an artifact, which is nice, but that's not super popular. I think we're just going to take it because it's a decent sideboard card, and if we get cards like Foul Emissary in the next pack or Primal Druid, I might just, we could just play this guy as a 6/5 for 5 that destroys something. Destroy something you care about. I like Wolfkin Bond, actually. This card's good. I don't think it's Dragon Strange Augmentation or Skurzdag Supplicant. Thraven Foulbloods is actually fine, especially if we are able to get Menace. Seems fine. It's a playable. Eh, we'll take the Woodcutter's Gift. Lost to that card the other day, unfortunately. Yeah, I don't mind having a Supplicant. I don't actually mind having a Spring Sage Ritual either. Heron's Grace Champion. Dang it. Dang it. So our rares were just terrible. We're going to take the Sombrerald Stag, though, because it's just fantastic. The only black cards are Vampire Cutthroat, which is not great, Gavinny Unhallowed, which is not great, and we have a Bloodbriar, which is fine, but it's no Sombrerald Stag. Haunted Dead is nice. Easy to discard with Cryptbreaker. I think it's better than Primal Druid, and I think it's better than Aid of the Horde Swarm. I think we're just taking the Haunted Dead here. We can also discard our Weirded Vampire to it. Oh, another Graphrats. I think we just want another Prey Upon here. I don't think we want a second Graphrats until we actually get a Midnight Scavengers. Yeah, I'll just take Prey Upon. That's a solid removal spell. Yeah, Olivia's Dragoon is good. Kind of passing these Primal Druids. I'd rather have the 2/2 that could be a flyer. Deck seems good so far. No super bombs or anything, but... Foil Lupine Prototype. We need to repeat you with the top card in your library. Yeah, it doesn't do anything for us. I mean, it helps Delirium, but I'd rather just not play it. Grapple with the Past could be good. I think it's actually fine. Helps us with the Delirium. It gets back Sombrerald Stag or Cryptbreaker. Seems good. Passing the Foil Lupine Prototype, unfortunately. I bet it's worth a whole nickel. Another Mockery of Nature. I don't want one of these, let alone two. Jeez. I guess we just take the Desperate Sent. I'm just going to take the best card in this pack. I'm not going to play a second Supplicant. I might even play one Mockery of Nature. Also, it's 8 to emerge, not 7. Oh, that's so much worse. Yeah, I'll just take the... let's take the Ingenious Scab. Scob? Eternal Scourge. 3/3 for 3. May cast it from exile. When it becomes its target spell or ability, exile it. Alright, well. Is that any good? No, it's not. It doesn't seem great. Probably rather have just Woodland Patrol. At least it's got an ability. Then again, a 3/3 for 3 is not terrible. Whatever. 3/3 for 3 is slightly overpowered in limited formats, so. And there was a bunch of silence there. Sorry about that, guys. Did the draft stop? Maybe. Feels like it sometimes. And so there's another pack that's pretty bad. Thirsting Axe is not great. Crossroad Consecrator. We don't really have many humans. Wailing Ghoul. We could just take Wailing Ghoul as like a crappy card to tap and... I'm just going to take Ironclad Slayer. I think it's probably the best card in this pack, and we're not going to play anything else that we get in it, so... take Borrowed Grace. It's a trick. Oh, and Aid of the Horrid Swarm might actually make the cut here. I could see us maybe playing a Waxing Moon, depending on what we get in the next pack. Not gonna put my money on it, but... could happen. Weirder things have happened. I'll just take the Guardian of Pilgrims. Yeah, so I think our deck looks good so far. And we still have another pack. We need about 5 playables. Maybe 4 if we play Waxing Moon, which is decent because we have Shrill Howler and Elvenwald Captive. Those are actually both pretty good to flip. Oh, man. Could we open worse cards? Like, not even a single black card that's playable. Like, Vessel of Malignity is not very great. I guess we just take Briarbridge Patrol. I mean, if we were white, we could easily take Nearhearth Chaplain. Red has some reasonable cards. I'm just going to take Briarbridge, I guess. I'm not thrilled about it. Warped Landscape is another option to help us with Delirium, but I think Briarbridge is better than that, so. But I don't think it's that great. Halpak Resurgence is interesting. We only have 2 wolves, right? There's so many cards that just get so much worse in the new set. Like when you add... I kind of like having a skeleton, but I might just like Watcher in the Web better. Oh, it's either Watcher in the Web or Skeleton here, I think. I think I like Skeleton better. Especially because of Cryptbreaker and Olivia's Dragoon. I just want to have a Skeleton. Oh, Obsessive Skinner. And Nephalia Moondrake? That's crazy. Also, Explosive Apparatus is definitely worth noting. I'm going to take the Skinner, though, because he's just insanely good. Oh, I like a Twins of Maurer Estates, especially with discard outlets. That's a good card. Can we get a Murderous Compulsion? That would be great. So, we could probably cut Thraven Foulbloods here. What? Hermit of Natternals and a Morcrut Necropod? This pack is insane! I want both of those cards, but I think we want the Hermit of Natternals a little bit more. Actually, this guy only costs 6. I always forgot this guy doesn't cost 7. Oh, this guy's so good. Oh, guys, what do we do? Ugh. I feel better about playing the Waxing Moon if we do have Hermit, but I don't actually care if I play it, I guess. I think we can take Hermit here. We have a lot of good cards on our top end that we're not terribly concerned with. I'm going to take this guy. I don't think any of these other cards are super relevant. Oh, I do like a Quilled Wolf. That is a pretty solid 2-drop. So this is 23, and I think I'm pretty comfortable playing this 23. If we get something else, I can easily cut, like, Supplicant, I guess. Actually, Graph Rats is pretty bad. Whereas I don't mind having a Thornhide Wolves. I'll just take a Moorland Drifter. It's a decent... I'll just take another Moorland. I don't care about Warp Landscape, just so you guys know. Take Milton. We're going to have a white deck in our sideboard, apparently. And we got to make one cut here. I don't think we want to cut any of the five drops, just because this one's more like a three drop. I think it's probably Graph Rats. Yeah, this deck looks sweet. We got some good removal. We have a couple of strong creatures. Double Prey Upon, which is nice. I would prefer to have a creature with Death Touch for our Prey Upons. We did get the Skeleton. No other Skeletons came back, which is nice, because I'd love to have a Skeleton with Gripbreaker and Olivia's Dragoon. Man, this... What is this going to be? I have two picks left, and these guys are taking their sweet time. Alright, we get the Alms of the Vein. Oh, Pieces of the Puzzle. Last pick. Someone was like, a land is better than this card. Alright. Pretty sure this deck is built. I don't think we're going to actually make any changes to it. We can sort by color here. We do have this for the sideboard, which is great. Kills an enchantment or an artifact. Waxing Moon flips, what, Hermit, Shrill Howler, and Elvenwald Captive. And none of these other cards are... Yeah, I think we're just fine. I think this is our deck. Let's check out the... We even had it of the Horde Swarm. We can sacrifice a Supplicant to that. Nope, don't sort by that. Sort by... Yeah, there we go. Alright, so we'll just add one more green. 9-8 seems fine, and we'll see you guys in round 1.